Have you ever seen someone talking to their growing plants and weren't sure if they were applying the latest scientific research on plant growth or were just plain old crazy? Well, you've come to the right place. Be sure to let us know what you think of the video down in the comment section below. And let's jump in. You may have heard that plants do better with a bit of verbal encouragement, but is this true? The idea that plants like being talked to is an old one, dating back to at least the mid-1800s, and it sounds at least somewhat plausible. When you talk, you send both sound waves and carbon dioxide into the air, either of which can affect the growing plants, and it seems to help babies in the womb, so why not saplings in the ground? Scientists have had more than a century and a half to investigate whether talking to plants helps them grow. And with all that research, we can finally say the definitive answer is maybe. We know that at least some plants can hear us talking. Or better put, they respond to sound waves with frequencies between 50 and 500 hertz, which the human voice falls within. And botanists have found that seeds germinate faster and plants grow better when played recordings of people talking. And they've seen increases in growth hormones and changes to gene expression in plants that have listened to music or single note tones. The theory is that plants may have evolved to react to changes in wind or vibrations from animal movement, which, like sound waves, would push on the plant cells. So plants hearing us may be sort of an evolutionary accident. The trouble with equating these results to you having a conversation with Fernie Sanders is that they usually play these sounds loudly and for hours at a time. So it's hard to know what the effects of a normal conversation would be. And since they were just playing recording sounds, these experiments can't tell whether your breathing plays a role. And that's a real hole in the research, because it's possible that the CO2 you exhale works like a sort of airborne fertilizer. Plants are able to convert carbon dioxide and water into sugars, which, like us, they need as biological fuel. When you exhale, your breath contains about 100 times more carbon dioxide than the air you breathe in, CO2 that your plant could use as fuel. Sadly, no national institute has yet funded a study with people just breathing on plants, so it's hard to know how much this would help. Overall, the research is inconclusive, but you might as well talk to your plants, because if you're stopping to chat them up, you'll probably pay closer attention to them, and will be more likely to notice if they need water, aren't getting enough light, or are being attacked by pests. After all, if you've ever had one of those succulents on your desk, you know, remembering to take care of your plant is most of the battle. Thanks for watching this episode of Everything Science. If you like these shorter videos, be sure to let us know in the comment section below, and click here to see our whole collection of quick bits. Have a great day, and remember, there is always more to learn.